Use cylindrical shells to find the volume of the solid obtained by rotating the region bounded on the right by the side of the graph of g of y equals 6 square root y, graphed in red, and on the left by the y-axis, graphed in blue, for y over the closed interval from 0 to 5 about the x-axis. So this is the bounded region R. And we're rotating this region about the x-axis, which should be here. Let's first take a look at this in three dimensions. On the left, we have the bounded region R graphed in three dimensions. If we rotate this area about the x-axis, we get the solid shown here on the right, and our goal is to determine this volume using the shell method. When using the shell method, we always want to sketch a representative rectangle that represents one shell or one tube of the volume when rotated about the given axis. When using the shell method, the representative rectangle is always parallel to the axis of rotation. When using the washer or disk method, the representative rectangle is always perpendicular to the axis of rotation. Let's use this rectangle as the representative rectangle. Notice the thickness of the rectangle is delta y, which indicates we integrate with respect to y. Looking at our notes below, because we have a horizontal axis of rotation, again, we integrate with respect to y, and the volume equals 2 pi times the integral from c to d of r of y times h of y dy, where r is the distance from the center of the rectangle to the axis of rotation, which means in our case, r of y is this vertical distance here. Notice r of y is simply equal to y over the closed interval from 0 to 5. And then h is the height of the rectangle, which in our case would be this horizontal distance. So r of y is equal to the horizontal distance x determined by the curve given by the equation x equals 6 square root y, which indicates r of y equals 6 square root y. And again, we're integrating with respect to y, and therefore the limits of integration will be from 0 to 5 along the y-axis. This indicates the volume v equals 2 pi times the integral from 0 to 5 of r of y, which is y, times h of y, which is 6 square root y, dy. Let's simplify the integrand function. We have 2 pi times the integral from 0 to 5 of, recall, square root y is equal to y to the 1/2 power, and therefore the integrand function is 6 y to the 3/2. Next, we determine the antiderivative. Don't forget about the factor of 2 pi, though. The antiderivative is 6 times y to the power of 3/2 plus 1, which is y to the 5/2, divided by 5/2, but dividing by 5/2 is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal of 2/5, which gives us 2/5 times y to the power of 5/2. Let's simplify the antiderivative. We have 12/5 y to the 5/2. Let's go ahead and factor out the 12/5 and multiply by 2 pi, which gives us 24/5 pi. And now we determine 24/5 pi times the difference of big F of 5 and big F of 0. Well, big F of 5 is equal to 5 to the power of 5/2 minus big F of 0 is equal to 0. Simplifying, we have 24 pi divided by 5 times 5 to the 5/2, which if we want to, we can think of as over 1. Simplifying, 1 factor of 5 simplifies out because 5 divided by 5 simplifies to 1. The 5 in the denominator simplifies to 1. The 5 to the 5/2 simplifies to 5 to the 3/2, because 5/2 minus 1 is 3/2. This indicates one way to write the exact volume would be 24 times 5 to the power of 3 halves pi, which is an acceptable way to express the volume. But 5 to the 3 halves can be written as 5 square root 5, giving us 24 times 5 square root 5 pi, which is equal to 120 square root 5 pi cubic units. Either of these two expressions would be correct for the volume, but it is important to recognize they are equivalent. I hope you found this helpful.